In this lesson, we will discuss barometers, which is a type of manometer. A barometer is a simple manometer that can measure atmospheric pressure. We start with a long, narrow tube filled with a liquid of specific weight gamma and a shallow pan that contains the same liquid. Both containers are open to the atmosphere. The long, narrow tube is inverted and placed into the shallow pan. This process must be done carefully so that no air enters the tube. Even though no air enters the tube, some of the liquid will flow out of the tube into the pan, creating an evacuated space at the top of the tube. Liquid molecules will evaporate into this space, and eventually an equilibrium will be established between the rate of evaporation and the rate molecules return to the liquid bulk. The pressure caused by the evaporated molecules at equilibrium is the vapor pressure, PV. The height of the liquid column H is dependent upon the liquid column's weight, the air pressure force pushing downward on the exposed liquid in the pan, and the vapor pressure force pushing downward on the top of the liquid column. We now apply Newton's second law in the vertical direction for just the liquid column. The sum of the forces acting on the column is equal to the column's mass times its acceleration. Since the column is at rest, its acceleration is zero. Next, we identify the forces acting on the column in the free body diagram. The column's weight acts at the center of mass and points downward. The vapor pressure at the top of the column pushes downward with a force equal to PV times the column's cross-sectional area, A col. Since the liquid column is not moving, there also must be a pressure force acting at the bottom of the column. Recall that the pressure does not change as you move horizontally through a static fluid. Let's label a couple of points on the barometer. Since point A is at the same elevation as point B in a continuous fluid, the pressure at point A must be the same as the pressure at point B. So the pressure force acting on the bottom of the liquid column is the atmospheric pressure times the column's cross-sectional area, A col. Newton's second law becomes the atmospheric pressure PA times A col minus the vapor pressure PV times A col minus the weight W. The weight is equal to the mass of the column times the gravitational acceleration G, and mass is equal to the liquid density times the volume of the column. And the volume of the column is equal to the column height H times the column's cross-sectional area A col. Notice that we have also combined density and gravitational acceleration into specific weight gamma. Plugging in the expression for weight into Newton's second law and eliminating A col, we have that the atmospheric pressure is equal to the liquid specific weight times the column height plus the vapor pressure of the liquid. So we can determine the atmospheric pressure by simply measuring the height of the liquid column H and looking up the specific weight and vapor pressure of the liquid, both of which are usually very easy to do. Historically, a common liquid used in barometers was mercury, here abbreviated by its chemical symbol Hg. Mercury was used because its specific weight was relatively high, approximately 13.6 times greater than the specific weight of water at room temperature. Looking at the barometric pressure equation, for a given atmospheric pressure PA, if the specific weight increases, the column height H decreases. In other words, using a liquid with a high specific weight, such as mercury, means that you could use a barometer with a shorter column length. For example, under typical atmospheric conditions, a mercury barometer would have a column height of approximately 3/4 of a meter, while a water barometer would have a column height of over 10 meters. So it is much more practical to have a barometer that uses mercury instead of a barometer that uses water. Mercury has an additional property that makes it a good choice for use in a barometer. For typical atmospheric conditions, the vapor pressure for mercury is many orders of magnitude smaller than the atmospheric pressure. So we can omit PV from the equation and are left with the atmospheric pressure being approximately equal to the specific weight of the liquid times the column height. Common units of barometric pressure are millimeters mercury, which is also called a torr, or inches mercury. At 15 degrees Celsius and 1 atmosphere of pressure, the column height of a mercury barometer would be 760 millimeters or 29.92 inches.